Hello dear children, welcome to inverse trigonometric functions. From the last two classes we are learning the properties of inverse trigonometric functions, and in today's class also we are going to learn few more properties of inverse trigonometric function. Already we learned four set of properties, okay, and today we are going to learn fifth set of property. So what it is going to tell, we'll see now, okay. So fifth set of property, in that the first property is sine inverse x plus cos inverse x, that would be pi by 2. Here the condition for domain will be closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, it's easy to remember because as you know already, the domain for sine inverse and cos inverse is already closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. So therefore, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2, where x belongs to closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, and the next property, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x, again it is pi by 2, as x belongs to set of all real number. Again here also it is same, the domain for tan inverse x is set of all real number, as well as the domain for cot inverse x is set of all real number. Therefore tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2, where x should be belongs to set of all real number. Okay, and the third property, cosec inverse x plus secant inverse x, this is equals to pi by 2, where mod x should be greater than or equal to 1. Again it is same, the domain of cosec inverse x and sec inverse x. Okay, so now we'll prove how to prove sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2. Okay, so now we'll prove the property number 1, that is sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay, so I'll consider the first property here, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x, that is equals to what? Pi by 2. Here you know the condition for domain is what? Closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. So here let me consider, to prove this property, let me consider sine inverse x. This is equals to what? Y. Okay. If sine inverse x is equals to y, what you are writing x? X will be equals to what? Sine y. Okay. X is equals to what? Sine y. Okay. So from the properties of trigonometric function, we can write sine in terms of cos. Okay. If cos of 90 minus theta is there, that is sine theta. Therefore, again, I am writing this sine theta as sine theta. I am writing cos of 90 minus theta. That one I am writing cos of 90 minus theta, pi by 2 minus y. Okay. Because if x is equals to sine y, we can write this sine y as in terms of cos. Okay. So that is what? Cos of 90 minus theta. If x is equals to cos theta is there, again we can write cos inverse x. This will be equal to what? Pi by 2 minus y. Okay. So again you know the value of y. So what is y here? Y will be what? Sine inverse x. That you substitute here. Okay. So cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2 minus sine inverse x. Again take sine inverse x this side. You are getting the property as sine inverse x plus cos inverse x. This would be equal to what? Pi by 2. Okay. So this is the property, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2, with x belongs to closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, so this is the property number 1, sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. To prove this, let us substitute sine inverse x is equals to y, or you can substitute cos inverse x is equals to y also. Then also you are getting the formula sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay. In the similar way you can prove other two properties also. Okay. So let me consider the second property. So what is the second property here? Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay. So let me go to the second property. The second property we are going to prove now. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. Okay. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2, where x should be belongs to set of all real number. Okay. So how to prove this property? To prove this property, again let me consider tan inverse x equals to what? Y. Okay, so we'll consider tan inverse x is equals to what? Y. So that we can write x is equals to what? Tan y. Okay. So again using the properties of trigonometric function, tan we can write in terms of cot, because we know already cot of 90 minus theta is tan theta. So therefore I am writing this tan y as cot of 90 minus y. Okay, so cot of 90 minus y, that is what? Tan y. Okay, so again, if x is equals to cot theta is there, again I can write cot inverse x is equals to theta. So that is, what is theta here? Pi by 2 minus y. Okay, so again, you know, what is the value of y? Y value is what? Tan inverse x. Okay, so that you substitute again. Cot inverse x, this is equals to what? Pi by 2 minus tan inverse x. Okay, so again send this tan inverse x to this side. So you are getting tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. This is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay, so these are very three important properties. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Here x should be belongs to where? Set of all real number. Okay, so got no students how to prove this property? Let me consider tan inverse x is y, so that we can write x is equals to tan y. Again I am writing tan in terms of cot, so that is only possible, that cot of 90 minus theta. So tan y can be written as cot of 90 minus theta. Okay, so if x is equals to cot theta is there, again we can write cot inverse x as theta. Therefore cot inverse x is equals to pi by 2 minus y. So again, you know the value of y. Y value is what here? Tan inverse x. That you substitute back. Okay, so again we are getting tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2, where x should be belongs to set of all real number. Okay, so we'll consider now third property. The third property is here, cosec inverse x plus secant inverse x. This is equals to what? Pi by 2, with the condition that mod x should be greater than or equal to what? 1. Okay, so we'll prove this property. So how to prove here? Again you can consider cosec inverse x is y or secant inverse x is y. Okay, so let us consider cosec inverse x. This is equals to what? Y. So that we can have x is equals to what? Cosec y. Okay, so to prove cosec x is equals to cosec inverse x plus secant inverse x is equals to pi by 2, convert cosec x in terms of sec. Okay, so that is possible only when sec of 90 minus theta is equals to cosec theta. Therefore I am writing cosec y as sec of 90 minus y. Okay, so therefore again we can write this one as what? Secant inverse x. This is equals to what? Pi by 2 minus y. Okay, so therefore secant inverse x is equals to pi by 2 minus, what is the value of y? The value of y is what? Cosec inverse x. So that you substitute back. Pi by 2 minus cosec inverse x. Again take cosec inverse x this side. You are getting cosec inverse x plus secant inverse x. This is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay, so here x mod x should be what? Greater than or equal to 1. The domain for x, that is what? Mod x should be greater than or equals to 1. Okay, so this is what? The fifth set of properties. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to pi by 2. And cosec inverse x plus sec inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2. Okay, so this type of properties are very important in exam. They can ask these through these properties for 2 marks. Okay, so got my students how to prove fifth set of properties. Okay, so we'll see how to use this property. Okay, so we'll see now how to use these properties. Okay, so I'll consider one example. Find the value of sine of tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. Okay, so they will ask, find the value of sine of tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. Okay, as you know already, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equals to what? Pi by 2. So therefore we can write this is equals to what? Sine pi by 2. Okay, so as you know already, the value of sine 90, that is what? 1. Okay, so again let me consider another example. Cot of sine inverse a plus cos inverse A. Okay, so here they can, you can write anything, not only x every time. Okay, so domain you can write sin inverse A plus cos inverse A, sin inverse B plus cos inverse B, but make sure that these two domains should be same. Okay, if it is A, this should be A. If it is A and if it is B, you can't write it as pi by 2. Sin inverse A plus cos inverse B is not pi by 2, only sin inverse A plus cos inverse A is pi by 2. Okay, so again you know the property, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2, that is sin inverse A plus cos inverse A, that is pi by 2. Therefore cot of pi by 2, the value of cot of pi by 2 is what? 0. Cot 90 value is what? 0. Okay, so like this we can apply property number 5. Okay, so we'll take now sixth set of properties. Okay, so what is coming in the sixth set of properties? The property number 6. Okay, so in that the first property is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy, where the product of x and y should be less than 1. Okay, so this is first property. And the second property, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, this is equals to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy, where x into y, the product of x into y should be greater than what? Minus 1. Okay, so in this particular condition only these two properties exist. Okay, so we'll prove what is the tan inverse x plus, how tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy is coming. Okay, so we'll take the first property now. The first property is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, that is equals to what? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by what? 1 minus xy, where the product of x into y should be less than what? 1. Okay, so to prove this property, let me consider tan inverse x is A and tan inverse y is B. Okay, so let me consider tan inverse x is equals to what? A. So then we can write, if tan inverse x is equals to A, we can write x is equals to what? Tan A. Okay, so again we can consider and consider tan inverse y, that is equals to what? B. So that we can get y is equals to what here? Tan B. Okay, so you know already the result, tan of A plus B. Okay, so consider the result, tan of A plus B. Okay, so you know this property from trigonometry, right? Tan of A plus B, we know the formula for tan of A plus B, that is what? Tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B. Tan of A plus B is equals to tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B. So that we can have here tan of A plus B, this is equals to, already you know what is tan A here? Tan A is x, that you substitute. X plus tan B, you know that is what? Y. So x plus y divided by 1 minus, you know tan A, that is x. Tan B what here? Y. Okay, so that is 1 minus xy. Okay, so if tan x is equals to theta, we can write x is equals to what? Tan inverse theta. So therefore we can write this one is equals to what? A plus B is equals to what? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Okay, so already you know what is A plus B. What is the value of A here? The A is what? Tan inverse A. B is what? Tan inverse y. So that you substitute. So what is A? A plus B we got. Okay, so A I am substituting, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, this is equals to what? Tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. Okay, so make sure that this condition would be used when xy should be less than 1. Okay, this condition is used only when the product of x into y is less than 1. Okay, If the product of x into y is greater than or equal to 1, that is another property. Okay, so only when x into y is less than 1, that time you can use this property. Okay, if x into y greater than or equal to 1, that is again different property, that is not recommended by NCERT for your syllabus. Okay, so this is only one property, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy, with the condition x into y is strictly less than 1. Okay, so this is in the set of property number 6, we got first property. Okay, so now we'll prove second property. So what is second property? We'll see. Okay, the second property is here, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Okay, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, this is equals to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy, with condition here the product of x into y should be greater than minus 1. Okay, so these are all very important properties, students. These properties are may going to ask in exam for 2 marks. Okay, prove that tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy. They can ask this one, or they can ask tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. They can ask that. Okay, so like these properties they can ask in exam for 2 marks. Okay, so how to prove this property? You can prove this property in already you learned property number 1, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Okay, so already you know the property. The property 1 I'll consider now here. Okay, see, tan inverse x plus tan inverse x is equals to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. Okay, to prove second property, you just replace y by minus y. Y by minus y, you are getting tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Okay, like this also you can prove, or else again considering like this, tan inverse x is equals to a and tan inverse y is equals to b. Okay, again we can prove this property. Okay, so to prove the property 2, let me consider again tan inverse x is a. Okay, let me consider tan inverse x is equals to what? A. If tan inverse x is equals to a, we can have x is equals to what? Tan a. Okay, and again we'll consider tan inverse y, so that is equals to what? B. Okay, so that we can have y is equals to what here? Y is equals to what? Tan b. Okay, so to prove tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, consider tan of a minus b. Okay, you know the property, that tan of a minus b property. So consider tan of a minus b. Okay, what is the property tan of a minus b? The property says tan of a minus b, that is equals to tan a minus tan b divided by 1 plus tan a into tan b. Okay, it's easy to remember the formula tan of a minus b. If it is a minus b, numerator sign will be minus, denominator sign is plus. If it is a plus b, numerator sign is plus, denominator sign is what here? Minus. Okay, so tan of a minus b is equals to tan a minus tan b divided by 1 plus tan a into tan b. So already you know, what is tan a? The tan a value is x, that you substitute. X minus tan b value is what? Y, that you put. X minus y divided by 1 plus, what is tan a? That is x. What is tan b? That is y. Okay, tan of a minus b is equals to x minus y by 1 plus xy. So that again we can have a minus b is equals to what? Tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy. Okay, so what is a? A is tan inverse x. What is b? That is tan inverse y. So that you substitute back. A is what? Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. So this is equals to what? Tan inverse x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. 1 plus xy with the condition x into y, the product of x into y, this should be greater than what? Minus 1. The product of x into y should be greater than minus 1. Okay. So we have proved the two properties. So what is the sixth set of properties? Is having two properties in that. So that is what tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy, where the product of x into y should be less than 1. The product of x into y should be less than 1. And the second property, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. The property is here, tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Here, the product of x into y should be greater than minus 1. Okay, it should be greater than minus 1. Okay, so these conditions are very important. And remembering these two properties is easy. How to remember tan inverse x plus tan inverse y? If it is plus, numerator is plus and denominator is what? Minus. And if it is minus, numerator is minus, denominator sign is what? Plus. Okay. So this is about property number 6. Okay. So these all very important. Okay. So now we'll go to 7th set of properties. Okay. So what are the properties are coming in the 7th set? We'll see. And how to use these properties, I will tell at the end of all the properties. Okay. So now we'll go to 7th set of properties. The 7th set of properties are coming. Here again, 3 properties we are getting. In that, the first one, 2 tan inverse x is equals to sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square, with the condition that mod x is less than or equals to 1. With the condition mod x is less than or equals to 1. And the second condition, 2 tan inverse x, that is equals to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square, with the condition that x should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay. In this particular domain only, this property exists. Okay. So, and the third property, 2 tan inverse x, this is equals to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. Here the condition for x should be, x is should be strictly greater than minus 1 and strictly less than plus 1. Okay, or you can write x belongs to open interval minus 1 to plus 1. Here you can write it as x belongs to open interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, so this is the property number 7. Okay, so these are also very important properties, and now we are going to prove these all properties. Okay, so let me consider the first property from property number 7. Okay, so what is the property number 1 here? The property 1 is what? 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine. Okay, tan inverse in terms of sine, that is what? Sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square, and here with the condition of the domain mod x is less than or equal to 1. Okay, so now we'll prove this property. Okay, so how to prove this property? To prove this property, let me consider this tan inverse x as y. Okay, let us consider tan inverse x is equals to what? Y. If tan inverse x is equals to y, what you are getting? X, x will be equal to what? Tan y. Okay, so let me consider RHS side of this one to prove this property. Okay, so what is RHS side? I will take RHS side of the property, sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Okay, so this is equals to, we have considered sine inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square to prove this property, that is RHS side. Okay, so I'll put now, you know already what is the value of x here? The value of x is what? Tan y. Okay, so that you substitute. 2 tan y divided by 1 plus x square. What is x square here? What is x here? X value is again tan. So that is what? Tan y whole square, that is nothing but tan square y. Okay, so What is the formula? 2 tan y divided by 1 plus tan square y. You know this one from trigonometry very clearly. Sin 2 theta in terms of theta. Okay, you know the property. Sin 2 theta in terms of theta. That is what? 2 tan theta divided by what? 1 plus tan square theta. Right? So, sin 2 theta is what? 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So, therefore, this is in terms of y. Therefore, we can write this one as 2 tan y by 1 plus tan square y as sin 2y. Right? So, this one we can write sin 2y. Okay? So, already you know from the first set of properties, sin inverse of sin x is x. Sin inverse of sin 2y, that is what? 2y. So what is y here? The value of y is what? Tan inverse x. So that you substitute back. So that is what? 2 tan inverse x. Okay. So we have proved the property 2 tan inverse x. Okay. We have proved the property 2 tan inverse x. That is equals to what? Sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. We have proved the first property as 2 tan inverse x, that is equals to what? Sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square with its domain. Mod x is less than or equal to 1. Okay, got no students? 2 tan inverse x is equals to sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square where mod x is less than or equal to 1. Okay. So, this is very important. So, this is the property in the set of properties 7. The first property. Okay. So, what I have considered? Tan inverse x is equals to y. Okay. Tan inverse x is equals to y. So, that we can have x is equals to tan y. To prove this property, consider RHS side of the property. Okay. RHS side. What is that? Sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. Therefore, we can have sin inverse of, okay, what is x here? X is tan y, okay, that you substitute. 2 tan y divided by 1 plus tan square y, okay. You know this result from trigonometry that sin 2 theta is equals to what? 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. So, therefore, we can write 2 tan y by 1 plus tan square y as sin 2y. Okay. Again, you know property 1 from inverse trigonometric properties. Okay. Sin inverse of sin x is x. Okay. Because what I used here? Sin inverse of sin x. That is equals to what? X. Okay. So, sin inverse of sin 2y. That is 2y. Okay. So, what is y here? The value of y is what? Tan inverse x. Okay. So, this is property number 1. Okay. So, we'll move to second property now with this. Okay. So, now I'll go to prove second property. What is the second property here? The second property is 2 tan inverse x. In terms of cos it is, right? So, 2 tan inverse x, that is equals to what? Cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square with the condition of the domain that x should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay. So, this is the second property. 2 tan inverse x is equals to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square where x should be greater than or equals to 0. Okay. So, now we'll prove this property. How to prove this property? Again, we'll put tan inverse x is equals to what? Y. Okay. So, let me consider tan inverse x is equals to what? Y. Okay. Tan inverse x is equals to y. So, that we can have what? X is equals to what? Tan y. Okay. To prove this property, again consider RHS side of this property. So, what is the RHS side? Cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. So, this is equals to cos inverse of 1 minus x square. What is x here? X is tan y. Okay. X square. That is what? Tan square y. Cos inverse of tan square y divided by 1 plus. What is again x here? X is tan y. So, therefore, x square. That is what? tan square y. Cos inverse of 1 minus tan square y by 1 plus tan square y. So again, you know, cos 2 theta in terms of tan, okay, from trigonometry you know this result very clearly, that cos 2 theta in terms of tan is 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So that you substitute here. Okay. So therefore we can write 1 minus tan square y by 1 plus tan square y as what? Cos 2y. Okay. So therefore again we, you know already this result. Property number 1. Cos inverse of cos x, that is equals to what? X again. Therefore cos inverse of cos 2y, this is written as what? 2y. What is y here? Y, you know already. Y is what? Tan inverse x. So that is what? 2 tan inverse x. Therefore we got the property cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. This is equals to what? 2 tan inverse x with the domain, with the domain that x should be greater than or equal to what? 0. Okay. We have proved the property, that is what? 2 tan inverse x, that is equals to what? Cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square, that is x is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. To prove this property, what I have did? Let me consider tan inverse x is equals to y, so that we can have x is equals to tan y. Then to prove this property, consider LHS side of this property, that is cos inverse 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square, that is written as x value, no, that is what? Tan y. Okay, so x value is tan y, therefore cos inverse of 1 minus tan square y by 1 plus tan square y. Okay, from trigonometry we know the result. Cos 2 theta in terms of theta is what? 1 minus tan square divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Okay, so therefore this can be written as cos 2y. Again, you know cos inverse of cos x is x. Therefore cos inverse of cos 2y is y, 2y. Therefore what is y here? Y we have considered, that is what? Tan inverse x. Okay, so therefore cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. So this is equals to what? 2 tan inverse x, where x should be greater than or equal to what? 0. Okay, so this is the second property from property number 7. Okay. So next, let me consider the third property. Okay. So we are going to prove now third property. So what is the third property here? The third property comes 2 tan inverse in terms of tan itself. Okay. 2 tan inverse x. This is equals to what? Tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square, with the condition that x should be strictly greater than minus 1 and strictly less than plus 1. Okay. I mean this property holds good in this particular domain only. Okay. So how to prove this property? To prove this property, again consider tan inverse x is equals to what? Y. Okay. So let me consider tan inverse x, that is equals to what here? Y. Okay. If tan inverse x is equals to y, again we can have what? X is equals to what? Tan y. Okay. So again, to prove this property, consider again RHS side. Okay. Consider the RHS side. What is RHS side? Tan inverse 2x divided by 1 minus x square. So this will becomes tan inverse of x, you know what is x, that is tan y, that you substitute. 2 tan y divided by 1 minus, what is so x here? X is what? Tan y. So that you substitute. 1 minus tan square y. Okay. So what is the value of 2 tan y by 1 minus tan square y? Okay. Again, we know from the trigonometry that tan 2 theta formula, 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Okay. So that we can write 2 tan y by 1 minus tan square y as tan inverse of what? Tan 2 y. right? So again, you know already the property number 1. What is the property number 1? Tan inverse of tan x. That is equals to what? X only. Therefore, tan inverse of tan 2y. So this will be equal to what? 2y. What is y here? The value of y is tan inverse x. Okay. So that is equals to what? Tan inverse x. So we have proved the third property, that tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. So this is equals to what? 2 tan inverse x. This is equals to 2 tan inverse x with the condition of domain x should be greater than minus 1 and x will be less than plus 1. Okay. So this is the third property from the property number 7. Okay. So 2 tan inverse x is equals to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. Okay. So here also what we have to put? Tan inverse x is equals to y, so that we can have x is equals to tan y. Again consider RHS side of the property, tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square, so that we can have tan inverse of, what is the value of x here? The value of x is tan y. Therefore tan inverse of 2 tan y by 1 minus tan square y. So therefore we can have tan inverse of, this is nothing but what? Tan 2y, because as you know this result. Okay. So again tan inverse of tan 2y is what? 2y, because of this result. Okay. So therefore we got 2 tan inverse x as tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square with the condition of domain x should be greater than, strictly greater than minus 1 and strictly less than plus 1. Okay. So from property number 7, we have learned 3 properties. Okay. From property number 7, we have learned 3 properties. What are those? 2 tan inverse x is 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine it is. Okay. In terms of sine. That is what? Sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. With the condition mod x is less than or equal to 1. And the second one, 2 tan inverse x, that is equals to what? Cos, in terms of cos, 2 tan inverse x in terms of cos, that is cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square, where x should be greater than or equal to what? 0. Okay. And the third result, 2 tan inverse x is what? Tan inverse in terms of tan. Okay. So tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square, where x should be belongs to open interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. So from property number 7, we are having 3 properties. That is what? 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine inverse, 2 tan inverse x in terms of cos inverse, 2 tan inverse x in terms of tan inverse. Okay. So this is property number 7. Okay. And what is the property number 6? The property number 6 is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to what? Tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy with condition product of x into y should be less than 1. Okay. And again the second property, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, this is equals to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy with the condition that the product of x into y should be greater than minus 1. Okay. So this is the sixth set of properties. Okay. Dear students, these properties are very important for the point of examination as well as for the point of knowledge also. Okay. So next, the fifth set of property, you know what are the fifth set of properties? Sine inverse x plus cos inverse x, that is equals to what? Pi by 2, where x belongs to closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. And the second result, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x, that is equals to pi by 2, x belongs to set of all real numbers. And the third property, cosec inverse x plus sec inverse x, that is equals to what? Pi by 2, where mod x is greater than or equal to 1. Okay. So how to use property number 6 and 7? Okay. How to use this property number 6 and 7 we'll learn in the next video. Okay. Property number 6. The uses of property number 6 and 7 we'll learn in the next class. Okay. Until then students, already now all the properties we learned. Okay. Here total 7 set of properties are there. Okay. From last 2 classes we learned 4 set of properties, and in today's classes we learned 3 set of properties, total 7 set of properties we learned. Okay, so you should be prepared with these all properties, and they may ask these properties to throwing the properties for 2 marks. Okay, so in the next class we are going to do the sums based on this properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, so until then students, bye bye, take care. For any doubts you can WhatsApp me. Okay, so thank you.